बहाने पग पग प्यारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
ग्रेट मॉर्निंग ग्रेट मॉर्निंग ग्रेट मॉर्निंग ग्रेट मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स Bhupesh Anand, once again, we are in prerequisites for CFA level 1 economics. We have completed two readings. The first reading is in relation to introduction, what is demand and supply analysis? And the second reading is in relation to consumer demand. So these are the basic concepts you should be aware of before doing that study session. And today, I will be starting with a new reading named as demand and supply analysis in relation to firm structure. Because I have to do a separate reading for firm and all that. So the basic understanding, the basic knowledge I should be aware of. So please take out your registers because we have to write down something. There are 4 or 5 lectures in this reading and I will be giving you knowledge in regard to that basic concepts. What is the meaning of economic profit? What is the meaning of economic rent? What is accounting profit? What is explicit cost? What is implicit cost? What I mean by opportunity cost? All the points we will be doing together. Please take out your register and I have written a quotation for you. We cannot learn without pain. It means we have to bear the pain. Then only we can learn. And when we bear the pain, we will be able to get that knowledge, you know. So demand and supply analysis, the firm. We are doing third reading, demand and supply analysis, the firm. Prerequisites for CFA level 1 economics, lecture number 1. So today, I will be starting with lecture number 1. And what I will be doing in this lecture number 1, this is learning outcome number A. I will be telling you what I mean by accounting profit, what I mean by economic profit, what I mean by explicit cost, what I mean by implicit cost, what I mean by economic value added, what I mean by economic rent. All the related concepts, very fun. We will be having very much fun in this. So let's start with the journey. The first point which I want to tell you is, what is accounting profit? When I say accounts, it means those profits which are being calculated as per income statement, as per book entry keeping, as per double entry bookkeeping system. Those profits which I calculate as per that, it is named as accounting profits. It means profit. When I say profit, it means accounting sales or the sales, the total sales or the total revenue minus the cost which I have entered in those books of accounts. And it is but natural that I debit explicit cost. Explicit means that which can be easily seen, which I have incurred. You know, that is named as explicit cost. So I will be telling you in detail what I mean by explicit and what I mean by implicit, what I mean by opportunity cost. So the first point is accounting profit, then economic profit, then normal profit, and this normal profit is in relation to economic value added. Economic value added, a new concept started by Stern Steward and Company, that the profit which we calculate as per profit and loss account, as per income statement, is not a profit. It is a manipulated figure. Rather, we should calculate economic value added, that is after paying the weighted cost to shareholders, to equity common shareholders, to preferred shareholders, and to debenture holders. If the rest remains, that is named as for economic value added. In India, the first company is the Tata Steel, who calculated his own economic value added, and that is coming as positive. So I will be telling you that also. So please take out your registers, my dear sir. First point which you have to write down, the profit which I calculate as per income statement, that is named as accounting profit. So accounting profit is equal to total revenue minus total accounting cost. Total revenue minus total accounting cost. It means how much sales I am getting and how much is the total accounting cost. And I have written explicit cost. When I say explicit, it means the cost which I have incurred. which is observed, which is paid, which I have entered. That is not implicit. There are two types of cost. One can be explicit and second can be implicit. Explicit means which is paid to the external parties. Now, there can be an implicit cost also. When I say a proprietor is doing his own business, but he is paying salary to his employees, he is paying rent, he is paying electricity, he is paying administrative expenses. So all that is explicit cost, all that is external cost. But the point is that proprietor has a qualification, he is a chartered accountant, he is an MBA by profession, and before doing this business, he was, you know, employed somewhere else. Let it be in Infosys. And in Infosys, he is getting 12 lakh rupees per annum as a package. Now, that salary he is not paying to himself, but that is a cost. So I will say that cost is named as opportunity cost, or I will say implicit cost. So here, while calculating accounting profit, I am only deducting explicit cost. Okay, so please write on first point, accounting profit. Accounting profit is equal to total revenue minus total accounting cost. Total revenue minus total accounting cost. And when I say accounting cost, it means that cost which appears in accounts. And explicit cost, which is being paid to the outsiders, actually paid, that is named as accounting cost. The second concept is economic profit. So this is a broader concept as compared to accounting profit. Accounting profit is, you know, is a smaller, you know, it is not so wider. But when I see the profit from economy point of view, that is named as economic profit. And when I say economic profit, I deduct two types of cost from this revenue. The first is accounting cost, that is explicit cost, and I will also deduct the implicit cost which I have paid. That is also to be deducted. So just see, there are different formulas for that. Accounting profit minus implicit cost. Because while calculating this accounting profit, we followed an equation, total revenue minus total accounting cost. This is the equation which we have followed. Total revenue minus total accounting cost. That is explicit cost. This is accounting profit. So in this, I have not deducted implicit cost. So if I go a step further and I deduct that implicit cost also, I will say that is named as economic profit. Or another way to calculate this, if I start from the beginning, total revenue minus total economic cost, I can say this is economic profit. Total revenue minus total economic cost. This includes explicit cost and this also includes implicit cost. Or I can say total revenue minus explicit cost and minus implicit cost. One of the same thing, you know. So these three formulas are just, you know, I am using that equation. So economic profit is equal to total sales minus explicit cost minus implicit cost. I can say it like this also, because total revenue minus explicit cost is accounting profit. So I can say accounting profit minus opportunity cost is economic profit. Or I can say total revenue minus total economic cost. Not that total economic cost is composite of explicit and implicit. And third is total revenue minus explicit minus implicit. So like this, you know, I can easily find out. So the next point which I want to tell you is that is named as explicit cost. Explicit costs are those costs which can be seen and observed. For example, I have just given you an example. Electricity expenses paid, rent paid, administrative expenses paid, wages paid. That's something which can be seen and which has been observed and which is paid to the outsiders or which have to be paid. That is named as explicit cost. Implicit, as the name indicates, implicit, you know, are those costs which exist. For example, a proprietor is doing the business in his own operations from his own old operations, and he's not paying actually rent, but that rent is an opportunity cost, or he's working himself and he's not drawing any salary. So that is opportunity cost. So that is named as opportunity cost. Implicit costs are those costs which exist, but not very clearly apparent or observable. Not very apparently, not very clearly apparently or observable. So just write down the example, rent on the own premises, rent on own premises. We are not actually paying it, but it is a cost, it is opportunity cost. Proprietor's salary on his own, his own salary, he is not drawing it, but it is a cost. So I have just told you in today's lecture that what is the meaning of accounting profit. When I say accounting profit, it means total sales minus explicit cost. Then I have told you what is economic profit. Economic profit is either accounting profit or total sales minus explicit cost minus implicit cost. Now total sales minus explicit cost is accounting profit. So we can say accounting profit minus implicit cost. So like this, you know, we can relate the things. The next point which I want to tell you is, I want to give you a case study, you know, so that we can get an idea that how we can calculate. So suppose sales is equal to 10 lakh dollars. Let the sales be 10 lakh dollars. Let the sales be 10 lakh dollars and let the manufacturing expenses be 5 lakh dollars. So 10 lakhs minus 5 lakh, let this will be the accounting profit, and accounting profit is 5 lakhs. So the owner of the business, Mr. A, he is a B.Tech qualified. I'm assuming that he is B.Tech qualified and he was employed in Infosys before doing this business. And there he was getting 4 lakh per annum as a package. I'm just taking the hypothetical figure. Don't take it personally. 4 lakh package. It means, first point is, I will say accounting profit is 5 lakhs because explicit cost is manufacturing and administrative expenses. Accounting profit only takes those costs which are seen and are paid and are observable. But the cost which is not seen, which is not observable, that is named as implicit cost. So 4 lakhs is the salary which he is paying, which he has lost. Cost benefit lost. So if I deduct that implicit cost, the balancing figure will be 1 lakh, and that 1 lakh is economic profit. So note number one, positive economic profit will increase market value of equity. It is but natural that if a company is doing positive, it means they are having a profit, you know, even after paying that implicit cost, after incurring that, after having the incidence of that cost, that is named as positive economic profit. And it will be it will be increasing the goodwill, the brand value, and hence the value of the equity, and vice versa for negative economic profit. So please write on note number one and note number two, negative economic profit or positive economic profit. The next point is economic value added, the concept which is being added or which is being started by Stern Stevedon Company calculated a new concept named as economic value added. It means the profit which is as per income statement is not the real profit because we are not deducting, you know, the dividend cost, because it is not compulsory to pay dividend to the shareholders, equity shareholders, common stock shareholders. Now it is compulsory to pay debenture holders interest, it is compulsory to prefer stock dividend, but to common stock it depends upon the company. But they have some expectations. So as per Stern Stevedon Company, the economic value added is a normal profit. I will say the profit which is calculated after deducting that implicit cost, which is even if not paid, but that has to be deducted. For example, dividend on shareholders. So please write on sixth point, economic value added. Economic profit. Firstly, I have written A point. Economic profit is accounting profit minus implicit cost. That is economic profit. Now this is the implicit cost which we have, you know, we have considered, and then, you know, from this economic profit we can calculate normal profit. So normal profit is equal to economic profit minus the dividend which is to be paid to the shareholders. So just write on B point, economic value added is normal profit for which economic profit equals zero. Normal profit is equal to accounting profit minus this. For normal profit is for opportunity cost of owner's time and resources. resources and expertise which they are giving. For example, if I talk of Mukesh Ambani in case of Reliance Industries, Mukesh Ambani is also giving his expertise, his experience and to Reliance Industries. It means the cost which is to be paid. It means he is incurring that Reliance industry, the cost which is there. No doubt it is not being paid to Mukesh Ambani, but that is a cost. So that will be also deducted at the, then the balancing figure if there, that is named as normal profit. So I have written a format for that. Then how with the help of format we can calculate those profits. So please write on my DSS E point. Very important, I am again telling you, very important. Following is the format or the sequence of calculating profits. The first is the sales, the total revenue minus explicit cost and implicit cost which I have paid. So it is sales, it is total revenue minus the cost which I have paid, which is inclusive of explicit as well as implicit which is paid. Balancing figure is accounting profit. If I subtract from that accounting profit the implicit cost which is not being paid, that is opportunity cost, you know, that then the balancing figure will be economic profit. So like this I can calculate this. Please prepare this format. Again, I am telling you, we will be doing some questions in this. So please prepare the format. And the last concept of today's lecture is economic rent. What is the meaning of economic rent? You know, sometimes we have seen that, you know, some supply of a particular item or a particular product is perfectly inelastic. It means irrespective of the price, the supply will remain same. For example, in case of petroleum, natural resources, whatever may be the price, the supply will remain same. Land, you know, the land is limited in supply. Whatever may be the price, the supply will be limited. So just write on 7th point, economic rent. It results when a particular resource is fixed in supply. It results when a particular resource is fixed in supply. That is when price of a construction increases. It means when something is fixed in supply, it will give rise to an economic rent. It means a product having perfectly inelastic supply. Perfectly inelastic, that product is having, you know, highest or greatest economic rent. So A point is, it results when a particular resource is fixed in supply. Second is, perfectly inelastic vertical supply curve, it will result in greatest economic rent. Just see the curve I have prepared, supply curve I have prepared. X-axis I have taken quantity, Y-axis I have taken price, and I have prepared a vertical axis. It means supply is constant, the quantity to be supplied, the land is constant. You cannot increase the land by increasing the price. So whatever may be the price, the land will remain same. So these types, so the rent on these types of assets, that is named as economic rent. So please write down, please prepare this graph. And the last note, there is no sensitivity in these types of products which have, you know, which are fixed in nature and they have the economic rent. There is no sensitivity and has no elasticity. So we will say perfectly inelastic and whatever may be the price. So let's see Google Baba what economic profit is saying. Economic profit means not only did you make a profit on your investment, but you make profit then you would have made otherwise. Economic profit is total profit, total income minus total expenses, and this economic profit versus accounting profit. So I have told you what is the meaning of this. This is how what is accounting profit and what is this. Accounting profit is we are subtracting sales, only explicit cost is there, but in this economic profit we are deducting, you know, economic profit is equal to we are deducting revenue from revenue, implicit cost and explicit cost. So you should be aware of what is the meaning of, you know, economic profit versus accounting profit. So I can easily find out that when and how I can calculate this profit, economic profit, total revenue is this much. All figures are even given to you. So hope you have enjoyed this. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.